Welcome to the VEX Robotics Competition Referee Training Videos. We've created this series of training videos for two reasons. One, to help VRC referees prepare for the current game, and two, to give VRC participants a better understanding of the thinking that goes into referee decisions. This year, we've produced a series of short videos on various refereeing topics that you can find here on our YouTube channel, VEX Robotics TV, or download directly from our website. Just a reminder, we've been producing these videos for a few seasons now. Make sure that you're always watching the videos for the current season. Our first episode, Chapter 1, is an overview of the referee position. We'll discuss what it takes to be a VRC referee and what the key roles are. Refereeing is one of the most challenging and rewarding volunteer positions in the VEX Robotics competition. Just like at sporting events, the referees are there to enforce the rules of the game. However, unlike traditional sporting events, VRC referees actually help the competitors to avoid breaking the rules. This is one of the key facets of being a VRC ref. We want referees who liberally warn teams about infractions before they occur to help educate them along the way. The key roles of a referee are making sure the field is set up correctly for each match, being cognizant of the schedule and keeping the event running on time, ensuring that teams are placed correctly at the field and prepared to compete, consistently enforcing the rules of the game as written, and completing and submitting an accurate score sheet at the end of the match. The key attributes an effective referee should possess are being an effective decision maker, confidently projecting authority, being assertive yet tactful, thorough knowledge of the game rules, strong communication skills, and attention to detail. Most events will have a head referee. This person is in charge of all refereeing and gameplay at the event. They will have some additional key roles, which include training all event referees and ensuring that they are fully versed in the game rules, working with the field manager to ensure matches are proceeding in a timely fashion, working with the lead inspector to ensure all robots are safe and rule compliant, making all final decisions and rulings, and discussing those rulings with teams. Through this series of training videos, we'll go over many specific situations and events pertaining to this year's game. But before we do that, here are some general refereeing tips. The referee's first role is to watch for violations and call them. The teams have put a lot of time and effort into the competition, so please help them before they violate the rules. It is the philosophy of the VEX Robotics competition to be helpful rather than punitive when it comes to refereeing. This means warning teams if they are close to being penalized. Often, as a referee, you can see when a team is about to violate a rule. Feel free to warn them about their potential actions. Second, be fair and consistent to all teams. All teams expect and deserve to be treated in the same manner. Third, always be friendly and positive. Remember, you set the tone for the event, and our goal is for all teams to have fun. Fourth, a referee's job is to enforce the rules as they are written, not as they think they should be written. A referee should not alter or add rules or penalize teams who do not play the game the way the referee feels is right. Fifth, when it comes to issues such as disqualifications and disablements, often referees will rule too leniently in order to avoid being harsh. Unfortunately, not penalizing a team for a rules violation results in directly penalizing their opponent. As unpleasant as it is, if a team violates a rule that leads to a disqualification, that team must be disqualified. It's the only fair thing to do. Also, disqualifications mostly occur in only match-affecting situations. For more details, please see Chapter 6 in this series. In addition, direct all team questions to the head referee. The head referee should be the only person discussing rulings with teams. When multiple referees are explaining rulings directly to the teams, inconsistencies in verbiage can easily arise. The head referee should explain all controversial rulings and close calls to the teams after all referees confer separately as necessary. When handled correctly, this level of communication is a positive experience for both referees and teams. All referees should also have read the VRC game manual prior to the event. At the event, make sure you have printed copies or quick access to digital copies of the manual for reference. A third option is to download the game app that includes complete rules and a handy search function. That's all for Chapter 1, but make sure to check out the other chapters on various specific refereeing issues.